Mr. Lai, I should just answer the phone and deal with that.
This is P. Butcher?
Yeah, first instalment shooter today.
Well, I'll tell you now, I'll be wasting my time, because she ain't got it.
No?
No, you know she hasn't. So how's she going to pay anything?
No, but it's her problem. And yours.
Mine?
Yeah, well, that's your job, isn't it? Collecting the repayments.
You didn't say anything about collecting off my own family.
Yeah, well, at the time I didn't know I was going to loan your family money, did I, Ricky? Anyway, even if I had, it wouldn't make any difference.
Yeah, well, it would to me.
Oh, I'm sorry, if I'd known, I'd have got a special contract drawn up. Ricky Butcher, collector of repayments from everyone except guide dogs, brownies, people driving blue Sierras, drinking pals and any living relatives.
You know what I'm saying.
Yeah, and you know what I'm saying. It's your job to collect the money, and I don't care if it's off your mum, your dad, or your Siamese twin brother. I ain't running a charity here, Ricky. Now, you get on with it, or I'll find somebody who will.
So if you write the orders down as you take, and that way you won't get mixed up, all right?
I do that anyway.
No, not always.
Well, most times.
Right, and, well, just keep everything as tidy as you can, all right?
Yeah, Grant, come on, we'll wait outside.
Yeah, I'll be right with you.
You're not leaving Easter in charge, are you?
Yeah.
Mum, you should have said I'd have got you somewhere.
Oh, they'll be all right, I will be.
Oh, it's up to you.
But I'll see you two later, all right?
Yeah, try not to burn the place down, will you?
That wasn't very tactful.
What was it?
Saying that in front of the girls.
I wasn't getting at them.
Well, it sounded lively.
Look, I'm just saying what I thought, and I think you're wrong leaving two kids in charge.
Sure, we'll see, won't we?
Yeah. Probably come back and find us in the right old state. Cindy's round the gate, just dropping Stephen off. So all we've got to do is pick her up. And the twins and then we're off.
Tell me, you're going to tell us one of your jokes?
Oh, funny you should mention that.
Oh, yeah,
no. What are working?
Come on, we're
off. Hey!
Theo?
And an accident investigation unit. I managed to open the driver's door and I saw that the driver, who I later found out was Rose Chapman, was bleeding profusely. At that time I thought she might be dead. The passenger, who I later found out was Peter Beale, was less visible because that side of the car had suffered most of the impact. They were both taken out of the hospital and pronounced dead on arrival. Along with the other officers, we sealed off the surrounding area.
Was there anything at the scene of the accident that led you to believe that this was anything other than a very serious motor vehicle accident?
No, sir.
Thank you, officer. I have no questions. Has any of the families any questions they'd like to ask this officer? In that case, the court will recess for lunch. Can we convene at 2 o'clock?
All right, now?
Yeah.
Send me over.
Come on,
let's
go and get a drink, eh?
Oh, fuck. We're gonna get away
with it. Yeah.
But we can't just let that happen.
We don't know they had anything to do with it, not for certain.
Well, they practically told us.
They could be winding us up. They could want us to think that. I mean, they could think the best way to get at us is to make us think they were responsible. We don't know him. We probably will never know. But if Pauline suspects that they had anything to do with it, if she suspects for just 1 minute, it'll send her over the edge. Is there any evidence of alcohol in the driver's bloodstream?
None whatsoever.
No indication of any medical condition which could have caused her to faint or render her unconscious?
No.
Prior to the accident?
No.
So you're satisfied that prior to the accident, Mrs. Chapman was in good health?
Yep.
Did you conduct a full post-mortem on the body?
Yes. The spleen was ruptured and the pelvis shattered.
Did you examine the vehicle at the scene?
No, sir, no. It was moved to the local police pound, where I did conduct a full mechanical and structural investigation.
So I had a gun.
The brake pad?
Yeah.
All right.
I noted that.
Is that a little smile, I say?
Yeah, it might have been.
So how'd you get up here?
A friend gave me a lift.
What, to Leicester?
Yeah, he had a family up here or something.
Oh, that was lucky.
Yeah, it was.
Yeah, Mum will be over tomorrow.
Was brake failed?
So you would say that the crash was a direct result of the brakes failing due to the lack of brake fluid?
Yes.
Why was there a lack of brake fluid?
Due to the poor condition of the vehicle.
Inquiry into the deaths of Rose Chapman and Peter Beale. I am recording a verdict of accidental death.
And that concludes the proceedings for this afternoon.
Good riddance to them both.
Oh, that's out of order.
Yeah, well, you know what they're like.
Yeah, well, you think they show a bit of respect? For Rose, if not for Pete.
Oh, people like that don't show. They blame her as much as they do him.
Yeah, well, it's done now. It's all over. At least Mum now can forget it and have the memory she wants.
Mm. A bit better?
Well, yeah, better than the other day.
Did you see where Ian went? Probably in the gents with Arthur.
Not when I was in there, Mum.
Typical of my son. Never there when you want him.
He's probably trying to get the coroner to take it alone.
How you feeling, Mum?
Oh, relieved. At last, Pete can rest in peace.
Yeah.
Thanks for coming, Shel. It meant a lot to me, and I know it would have meant a lot to your Uncle Pete.
I know.
Just pleased we don't ever have to see that awful family again.
I think we're all pleased about that, Mum.
Can you believe this? Where are they?
I'll go look for them.
Oh, don't you get lost as well, Shel.
If you think I'm going to forget about it, then you are wrong.
Ian. So what are you going to do about it?
Oh, then, you'll see.
It's accidental death. You heard the man. Case closed. End of story.
Do you want to bet? Do you really want to bet?
I want to bet. Look, we warned him. He wouldn't listen. He only got what was coming to him.
I'm going to have you for this.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, I'm telling you, I ain't done.
Ian, leave it.
I'm not finished. Ian. You ain't going to get away with this.
We already have, pal.
Huh? What was all that about?
No.
It didn't sound like nothing to
me. It was just normal aggravation. He got carried away. He let them rile him.
What were they saying?
Nothing.
Dad, I heard...
Look, honestly, Shelley, it's nothing. It's best we forget it, eh? We need never see that family again. Now, come on.
Sorry.
All right, Cindy. You look a bit worried.
No, I'm all right. Ian's gone to see the bank manager.
Oh, bad news.
Well, we'll just have to see, won't we? I'm sure it'll be all right. You know what Ian's like, though. He's been all cagey about it. Keeps fobbing me off whenever I ask him.
He never learns, does he?
Sure. Oh, speak of the devil.
Oh, there you are.
Can I get you anything, lad?
Yeah, have a cup of coffee, please, Mum.
So, how'd it go then?
Oh, I think we came to an agreement.
Well, should I be pleased?
I think relieved's a more apt word. Look, I won't bore you with all the details. I mean, I had a job following most of it myself, but basically, I'm being far too lenient with all my clients. And pretty soon, their financial worries are going to become our financial worries.
There you go, love.
So.
Everything all right at the bank, was it?
Yeah, fine.
Oh, good. Right.
What have you been telling her?
I only told her you went to the bank.
Wish you hadn't.
That's all I said. What's the big deal?
We should start thinking we're in trouble again.
Well, are we?
No. We've just got a cash flow problem, that's all.
You mean you've borrowed too much?
No, my clients aren't paying back what they've borrowed. John, I should never have lent the people around here in the first place. I'm having far less problems getting payments from people outside the square.
You should never got involved in any of it in the first place.
Oh, don't start again.
So what you mean you're going to have to start coming down hard on people, is that it?
I don't want it, love, believe me, but... Anyway.
Yeah.
Satisfied? Pat?
You're not trying to avoid me, are you?
No, of course not.
Come on, Ian, leave it. You've got your money.
Yeah, but it wasn't the amount we agreed, was it? What about this week's interest payments?
I don't want to talk about this now, Ian.
Look, I've got bills to pay and all, you know.
Try and pretend you're in the same boat as me.
Look, Pat, I'm sorry. I'm just trying to run a business, that's all. I've got to come down on you or my lenders come down on me.
Ian, leave it.
I'll pay you back what I borrowed, but you can stuff the interest, understand?
No way.
Just leave me alone.
Fair. I want a word with you.
You can't have one.
What?
I don't know how you can do it, handling people like this when they've got nothing. I don't know how you sleep at night.
Ricky, don't let it get so personal.
Well, it is personal. Pat's just about the only family I've got left right now, and you're knocking her into the ground. And I can't believe I've been helping you.
Well, you've got no choice, have you? It's your job.
Yeah, well, you can stuff your job.
We didn't have to come, you know.
No, I did, after the day I've had. Hey, you know what? I'm going to get myself one of them black capes and a little twirly moustache.
Eh?
You're beginning to feel like a riot villain.
Well, you asked for it.
Thanks, love.
Hi, Joe.
Oh, Ian. How nice to see a client who's pleased to see me.
Yeah, well, not exactly. I was just going to come to see you, actually.
To pay up?
Well, actually,
Don't tell me. You're not going to pay this week.
The thing is, I was wondering if we could do, you know, like what we did last week again.
Oh, what was that? Go for a drink? Have a game of darts?
No. Take the latest payment onto the loan. I mean, I know it's a bit of a cheek asking Ben, but what with their wedding and everything, you know?
Yeah, I forgot you were getting married. That costs a bit, I know.
Yeah, so I've heard. Any chance of us coming to some sort of arrangement, you know?
Yeah, I think so. Yeah, but Nigel?
Yeah?
You've got to start paying this money back sometime.
Yeah, I know.
I'll see you next week.
Yeah, see you, Ian. Cheers.
Cindy! What's happening?
Geeta came home. She's got Mina with her.
Mina? Are they talking? Well, have they made up?
Well, I don't know. Go find out.
Yeah, I will.
Believe it. One of these days, I'm going to come home from work and they're going to be sat there, totally growing up. And they've got such different personalities as well. Right? Little Peter, he'll give in more easily than Lucy. I mean, she'll just sit there screaming until she gets her own way. Cindy reckons she's more like me. What do you think?
I don't know.
Well, you must have an opinion, Mum. You've seen him as much as anybody.
My mind's elsewhere just at the moment, Ian.
Yeah, I thought as much. What is it? You got a problem? Look, if it's money, Mum, you've only got to ask.
Just wish it was.
It's Phil, isn't it? Look, tell me if I'm being out of order, but... Well, I've heard he'd been in the bottle a bit.
It's nothing to do with Phil.
No?
No.
What's up?
It's Richard.
Not him again. What's he done this time?
It just upset me, that's all. Maybe I'm being silly, but... Well, he really knows how to get to me.
Yeah, he's good at sticking a knife, isn't he? Come on. Nigel!
Oh, hi, Ian.
Got any new titles in?
Yeah, I have. Anything in particular?
No, just something recent, something the wife ain't seen. I'll pop in later, all right?
Yeah, Ian, if you do, and Debbie's in here, which, you know, she could very well be.
And don't tell her about the loan, is that what you're trying to say?
Yeah, that's it. How do you know that?
Well, my job's a bit like being a priest, isn't it?
Is it?
Yeah. People come to me and confess they've been stupid with their money and they're about to be cut off by the gas. I grant them absolution and they go away happy.
What do you mean, absolution?
I tell them it's okay to be in debt and that their penance is to pay me X amount per week. I mean, also like a priest to keep me gob shut. Right, just dig up something recent. Something with some good-looking blokes and, you know, keep her happy, all right?
Yeah, right.
See you later.
Yeah, see ya.
I want a word with you. What have you been saying to my mum?
I don't know. I've not been saying out to her lately. Well, I mean, except to give us a cup of tea, Kath, you know, bacon, egg, sausage.
What about the sleazy stuff?
I'm sorry, but I'm not with you then.
The stuff you said to her this morning.
Oh, she's not taking offence at that, is she? I was only kidding her on.
Look, she don't like that kind of talk, and I don't want to ever hear of you talking to her like that again.
Hey, listen, mate, don't you get involved, okay? You don't know the half of it. Now, me and your mum, we were an item once, do you remember that? Yeah, well, when you've had what me and her have had, it didn't just go away overnight. There's a lot of history there. And a lot of feelings that haven't quite died.
That is rubbish. I know my mum, she can't stand the sight of you.
Wrong, you don't know her at all. There are ways that I know your mother that you will never know. She's a sexy lady. And I still think about some of the times that we had, and I will always think about it. So don't you get involved. Okay? I don't know what's wrong with you lot. Can't get a civil word out of any of you.
Are you surprised?
Well, yeah. I am, as a girl,
yeah. Yeah, well, none of us know what's wrong with you. All you do is go around stirring things and spreading lies.
What lies?
All the stuff you said about me and now you started on Kathy.
Whatever I said about Kathy was the truth.
Oh, yeah? Well, I heard different.
Oh, yeah. And what am I supposed to have said? See, all I said was, I thought Kathy was good in bed, and I didn't think Phil could satisfy her.
He what?
What's wrong with that?
Hi.
Hi, thanks. How are they?
Oh, they've been as good as gold. Better than mine ever were.
Probably because you like them better.
You may be right. Much as I hate to admit it, you probably are.
I can't. I want to know what's wrong.
I said, leave me alone, all right?
Kath, what's going on?
I wish I knew, but Phil's been horrible.
Why?
I don't know. He won't say it. I don't know if I'm supposed to have done something or what.
He doesn't be talking to Richard by any chance, is he?
Why?
Listen, bad-mouthing you like the place, that's why.
Saying what?
What about you and him when you were together? You know this sort of thing. You know how jealous men can be. Maybe I'd go out Phil as well.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Grant. Happy birthday to you.
Grant's birthday, have a bit of cake. Blow that, darling. Oh, well done.
Do you think we'd get offered some?
Choke.
Oh, I don't know. Cake's a cake, even if it is macho man's.
You all right, Phil?
Yeah, it's all.
You're looking a bit rough.
Very probably.
He's been drinking for days. I reckon he's going for a new world record.
So what? If you don't like it, you know what you can do, don't you?
Shall I have a bit of cake, Kate?
No, thanks.
Yeah, I'll have some, Sharon. Just the plate. Oh, this looks lovely, Shel. We should try some.
Very nice, Tom.
You gonna tell me what's going on between you two?
Nothing.
You know, I hate it when you lie to me.
No, Mum. Yeah, you ought to try and tell me to take four and go. It's really nice.
Yeah, I wonder where Sharon got it from.
Look, is he all right? Excuse me. Well?
What can
can I say?
Excuse me. Can we have some cake too?
Sure. I just need to know why.
I can't tell you, but it's not you, I promise you.
Has somebody said something to you? Has Richard been talking to you? Look, I know he's been going around saying hateful things about me to Ian and Cindy, but has he said something to you and all?
Yeah. Yeah, he did, as it happens, and it really upset me.
Yeah, I knew it. Well, what did he say?
Well, don't want to tell you.
Is that what all this has been about? Because of what he said to you?
Yeah. I'm sorry I took it out on you.
Quite a log of that, please.
But why does he want to split us up? Kill him, I really could.
Two white wines, two pints of lager, and a large scotch.
Who's the scotch for, you?
Yeah, why?
We don't need that, Phil.
No, but I want it.
Phil, please.
I can't do anything without you having a go at me, can I? Well, I'll tell you what, I've had enough of it, all right? Listen, cancel that house, then.
What are you doing?
I ain't buying you lot of drinks, you just get on my nerves, all right?
Phil, where are you going?
I'm going home. You got a problem with that?
Right, who's going to pay for this lot, then?
Oh, looks like me, doesn't it?
I'm sorry, Ian.
Ah, it's all right, Mum. It's not your fault, is it?
I just don't know what's going on.
Here, I'll have a glass of wine.
Oh, come on, don't do that.
I'm sorry. Oh, no.
What's all this then?
Oh, why don't you just push off?
Oh, that is very nice, that. Here am I, all set with a knight in shining armour, and you're somebody to push off. Boyfriend breaking your heart, is it?
Oh, just leave her alone, will ya?
I could have told you it wouldn't work, yeah. Are you and Phil Mitchell? It's a bit like Beauty and the Beast, isn't
it? Yeah, will you just tell him to leave me alone,
please? Look, you heard what she just said.
No, I didn't quite catch it, actually. What did she say? Tell Richard what I need is a real man.
Oh, you...
Mum,
hey,
don't act the innocent. We know you've been spreading dirt about him, Mum.
Don't make me laugh.
Laugh? You won't be laughing when we do you for slander.
I want to do it for assault instead.
Oh, yeah!
Ian, are you all right? Ian!
Oh, he's done it now.
Oh, my God.
I'm going to kill him.
Ian, look, don't forget about it, right? It's not worth it.
You watch me. I'm going to get him for this.
That. What are you doing just standing there?
You all right, Nodge?
Hiya. Sorry to disturb you. I mean, went round the office, but you weren't there, so... don't you look a picture, eh? Proper little family group. Yeah.
So, have you come round with some sort of repayment, have you?
Well, no, actually, I haven't come round to repay you. Not just at the moment, anyway. The thing is, you know I'm getting married tomorrow.
Oh, yeah, you're all set?
Yeah, more or less. Well, the thing is, promised Debs and Claire a date to remember, so I've told them to go off and kit themselves out.
Oh, what's Debbie wearing?
Well, she's got her eye on this sort of dress thing. Not white, of course, sort of beigey cream.
Oh, sounds nice.
So you want some more cash tacked on what you've already borrowed?
Yeah, a couple of hundred should see me clear.
Sorry, Nodge. Can't be done.
What?
Look, I ain't being nasty or anything. Look, I know you want to have a really great day tomorrow. I'm sure you will. I've got a responsibility to make sure you have a really great life afterwards. Now, you're already in hock to me for what? 500 quid? Well, you haven't exactly been forthcoming with the repayments on that. There's all the interest that's ticking up on it. Believe me, Nigel, I wouldn't be doing you any favours by lending you more money.
Ian, I need 200 quid.
Sorry, Nigel. Can't do it.